Hi guys, I'm James, driver for the Mercedes-AMG Petronas eSports team, and I'm sat here with test and reserve driver for the F1 team, Fred, and one of the Trackside team engineers, Marcelo. So Marcelo, what exactly do you do at the race weekends?
Yeah, I'm a senior Trackside control systems engineer, so I look after most of the electronics on the car, and of course, the steering wheel being one of the main components that falls under that responsibility.
Yeah, and I guess you've worked quite closely with Fred over the years.
Yeah, I've been fortunate to have Fred in the car in a few tests and events, and gone through the process of trying to make him feel comfortable with the systems. And of course, a big part of that is the steering wheel. It's up to sort of Fred and myself to sort of go to the basics, have something that is already quite, hopefully very intuitive, and just kind of hit the main points to get the job done.
Yeah, I mean, I've had for a GT3 car, the manual, and I've already been like a bit confused by it, and it took a lot of reading to get used to it, but with a Formula One wheel, it must just be like another level.
Yeah, for me, what helped me a lot was the simulator. So to be able to go through everything in the sim and basically like test everything and do it over and over, that really helps me to just jump into the car and feel familiar.
So the reason we're sat here today is we have the official Mercedes-AMG Petronas Formula One Team Sim Racing Steering Wheel 2024. It's quite a long name. Along with the F1 wheel, which you're both probably more used to than this one. Very similar off the face of it, but Marcelo, you've worked very hard on developing what we have in front of us today. How did it go and how complicated was the process?
I have to say, they've done an amazing job. Even for somebody like myself that works day in, day out with this F1 steering wheel, to look at this sim wheel, like you actually had to spend like a little bit of time looking at it, actually feeling it, and it's still difficult to make out which one's which, which I think is a testament to the fantastic job that they've done in creating this sim wheel.
I'm excited about this. I've spent, of course, a lot of time with this one in the Mercedes F1 simulator, and of course also in the real car, but to be able to have this at home in my own sim, that's pretty exciting.
I heard it's exactly the same CAD model that made that, which to me blows my mind. So from an engineering standpoint, they are identical.
They are. It is really special that is something that is now available. Formula One has always been so secretive and so protective of the intellectual property, and now we're putting it out there. We want people to experience it and be able to have something that is exactly the same as what the race drivers have.
What's the wheel like when you're driving an F1 car? What is that wheel actually like?
For me, something that's really important is like when you're at 320 kph down the straight in Monaco, everything is shaking, you're up against the wall.
Yeah.
It's really important that you can reach the button very easily with your thumb. You can make the change you need to make very quickly, and that it just happens almost by itself. That's so important. It's definitely cool to be able to share what is in F1, to share that to the eSport world. That's something that's quite special, because eSport has a lot of nice wheels around, but nothing that just screams Formula One like this one.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's really cool that all the needs in F1 are now accessible to anyone. I mean, for a sim racer, the main things for me are the wheel's not too big, so your hands aren't too far away, because otherwise correcting oversteer moments is like really tricky. If it's close together like this, you can react quite quickly. As you said, you know, the buttons are accessible very easily with your thumb. You don't have to move your hand around too much. You've got the screen, obviously, for more data. So I think everything you'd need as a sim racer is basically in front of me, because, you know, if an F1 driver needs it, it's there. So surely a sim racer is going to have everything he needs as well. People looking will be like, does this make me faster? And I'm like, I don't know if it makes you faster, but I think, as you say, in those stressful moments in a race when you've got someone right up behind you, there's two laps left, you need to press a button to change the diff or something like that. If you've got a wheel that's, you can do it easily and you know exactly where it is, and you know, I think that makes a difference, you know, the feeling you get as a driver.
Definitely, as a driver, if you can minimize mental load in the car, And it's small details. If you look at Formula One, everything is details. And the same for the esport world, it's really those small details that makes the difference. So as a driver, if you just feel that everything is intuitive, everything is just in your hands, you know what to do without thinking about it, that will help you in the sim for sure.
So I guess a question people want to know is why there's so many buttons on the wheel. Yeah, and on the F1 car itself, you'll know better than anyone why that is and what they're for.
Yeah, that's a fantastic question, and it's something that we get asked a lot. And I think the best way to describe that is the fact that us as engineers and the complexity of a modern Formula One car is such that there are so many parameters that can be adjusted electronically and software-wise to assist the drivers. But of course, we can only present them with a subset of those functions. So the philosophy behind what we actually put on the wheel is what are the things that will have the most impact, again, performance-wise, across the different phases of a race. And the main things that come into play are the ability to change the characteristics of the car in how it manages in different corner speeds, and just managing, for example, the tire degradation and the fuel load across an entire race. All those things change the balance of the car significantly. Fred can tell you how much of an impact those changes can have.
Yeah, so as a driver, we use all of the settings, all of the buttons. You kind of find your own rhythm when the car changes, in which direction you want to move the car, and you start to learn about each button. So for example, the differential, there is three, even four different ways you can change it just on the wheel. You got the brake balance, you got the brake migration, you got the DRS, you got so many different things in Formula One, and that's why it's full of buttons.
You know, the rotaries are identical from what I've heard, but the travel time on the F1 car wheel is longer. I guess because the driver, the last thing they want to do is flick a button by accident and make a mistake and accidentally engage the pit limiter, for example. Whereas on the sim, you're not really worried about that because you've not got the G-force, you know, moving your body around and stuff. So you just need the button to be pressed as quickly as possible. So that is a difference. Don't know what you guys think about that. I mean, to me, it makes sense.
Yeah, I mean, as a driver, the functionality is exactly the same. So there is no difference between the two. The feel is slightly different from the F1 wheel to the sim wheel, but it definitely makes sense that on the sim wheel, you just want a quick button that does the job. Where in F1, you want the safety. As you said, you don't want to be in a corner and then suddenly press the, by accident,
be disastrous,
the limiter.
Yeah.
That can change a race result.
Yeah.
I think it's a great example in how the sim wheel has taken the part that matters the most from the F1 wheel, which is how do you help the driver go faster?
And like the philosophy of it. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. So in that particular environment, a change, a small change, is what will allow you to maintain the ethos of Formula One, which is make it faster. Anything that you're doing should make you have higher performance. So that is a very conscious decision to say we will modify the throw of the button because that is what works best.
Because it'd be better in the sim racing environment.
Exactly, yeah. Because the first and foremost, the thing that we want to translate from the Formula One world into the sim world is performance.
So the screens are slightly different as well. Could you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, again, I think the pretty minor differences are primarily the screen protection, which in the Formula One wheel is primarily because of ambient conditions, rain, and regulation-wise, you have to have a different sort of protection in it that doesn't allow it to be polarized and things. But other than that, they're pretty similar from a functionality perspective.
Right, so they wouldn't notice the difference necessarily?
No, not really. And again, I think the most important thing there is that the information that is being presented on the screen is all available, which is something quite remarkable because we've talked a lot about all the functions that you have available to you as a driver to modify certain settings in the car, but we haven't talked about all the information that you're now being able to present the driver to, again, help you with the different race scenarios.
We've done a sim race or two together. Earlier in the year, we did Daytona, the iRacing special event, which was good fun. And you're pretty quick on a sim, I think that's fair to say. So what do you look for in a sim wheel? You know, does this fit the bill? For me, it does. I know it does, but.
Yeah, for me, it definitely does as well. It's a great wheel. It looks great, but it most importantly feels great. Something I love with the F1 wheel, but also the sim wheel, is the grip. Especially if you wear the race gloves or any kind of gloves, it really grips nicely. And that's something you just need in a wheel.
Yeah.
The main things I look for is, like, is it the right width? So 280 millimeters in diameter, I think that's perfect. You're not too wide or too narrow. Has it got enough buttons? Are the shifters the right sort of stiffness? Because if they're too stiff, you can't really go down the gears like you'd want to. If they're too loose, those three things alone, it's unbelievable. But there's so much more to it.
For me, something I love with sim racing, which this wheel provides, is the dash that you can change it. Obviously, it's pretty cool that you can have the same dash as the real F1 car. But if there's any data you want to have available on the wheel, you can actually just
change it.
It takes 10 seconds.
Have whatever you want.
Exactly. You can modify it into what you need to have the maximum performance. And I think that's special about this wheel.
So guys, I think, you know, SimLab have done a fantastic job getting the quality and durability of the F1 wheel into the sim racing world. It's been an absolute joy to use it. I'm sure you both are the same, you know, you've enjoyed using it. I can't wait for everyone else to try it. It's going to be amazing to see their reactions. But thank you for watching, and see you soon.